I'd like to draw your attention to the topic of glass, and in particular, buildings. Not a human structure, probably the world over, that doesn't contain a piece of glass. The dark side is that birds, unfortunately for them, cannot see glass as a barrier. And so they're deceived, and they fly into these glass facades, killing or injuring themselves in huge numbers.
I'm standing in the Acopian Center for Ornithology. The birds that die during these tragic collisions are deposited in museums like ours, where they're used for education and other research purposes. This is a merlin with an interesting background in the sense that it captured prey and flew with the yellow-rumped warbler in its talons right into an adjacent window where both birds were killed outright.
Our responsibility as humans is to address this issue, and there are solutions. Glass is a source of danger for birds. Occurs in two forms. One in which the glass is clear and habitat and sky can be seen on the other side of the clear panes. This is very obvious in atria or in linkways or corridors between buildings. And the other more prominent installation of glass that creates an illusion and a deception for birds is a reflection. I have conducted a number of detailed objective experiments to reveal what it takes to transform a window, whether it's a see-through window or whether it's a reflective window, into a barrier that birds will see and avoid. The detailed scientific research tells us that we can protect them by changing the glass with patterns.
And Muhlenberg College has installed a ceramic frit dot pattern. These dots are 1/8 inch in diameter, and they're separated by about 3/8 of an inch. When you look through the window, when you're close at hand, like I am now, it looks formidable to look through. But if you step back just a few feet, you can see through just fine. This particular window has been very effective in preventing strikes. No birds have struck it since it's been installed in 2007. And we're hoping that this particular product, not only here, but elsewhere, outside the college in commercial and residential homes, will find a home to prevent bird strikes.
These patterns are applied on the first surface of windows, and they consist of elements that are separated by 2 to 4 inches, often referred to as the 2x4 inch rule.
But if you apply the 2x4 inch rule using ultraviolet signals, which are visible to birds but not humans, this I've often referred to as the elegant solution. People are able to look through their windows without having any obstructions in their way, and birds are still able to identify those windows as barriers to avoid. There's only one manufacturer, at least to date, that has been successful in doing this. From a research grant that I had from them, I was able to validate that their product was effective. Brand name called AviProtect, and the company that produces it is Walker Glass in Montreal. And this particular sample is the image that these birds are able to recognize as barriers to be avoided, and in so doing, save their lives.
They help plant trees for us. They have many utilitarian value for human beings, not the least of which is the billions of dollars that are spent every year in recreation. So that humans not only are interested in the birds, they're interested in this really senseless, this unintended and unwanted killing of these animals at our structures, and we're seeking to have both the value of glass and make it safe for the animals we seek to preserve.